Welcome to clickmyproject.com. Now we discuss about the product brain tumor segmentation based on local independent projection based classification. Now we discuss about the abstract. Brain tumor segmentation is an important procedure for early tumor diagnosis and radiotherapy planning. Although numerous brain tumor segmentation methods have been presented, enhancing tumor segmentation is still challenging because brain tumor MRI image exhibit complex such as high diversity in tumor appearance and tumor boundaries. Although we propose a novel method for segmentation and also rectify the complexity of classification method, we use the novel classification LIPC algorithm. It is abbreviated as the local independent projection based classification. The segmentation and classification is evaluated in many data set, hence the process is more reliable. Hence it is more efficient, and also it has classified the tumor and as well as the non-tumor region. As the feature extraction, it has more reliability and stability for the process. Now we discuss about the flow diagram for the process. At first, the input image is taken from the data set. Then the data set image is undergoing for the pre-processing step. The pre-processing steps contain the noise filtering. The noise filtering is nothing but the filtering the noise in the image. In the noise removing, we use the Gaussian filter for the noise remover. Then tumor detection is carried out after the pre-processing. In the tumor detection, we have used the threshold for segmentation. The threshold value is getting from the image. Then the feature extraction is carried out after the segmentation. After the segmentation, the feature extraction is carried out using the texture feature. The texture feature is extracted using the LBP. LBP is abbreviated as an local binary pattern. Then the classification is undertaken after the feature extraction. Classification is done using the LIPC method. In classification, we have considered the major three things. One thing is train feature, then next thing is test feature, and then label. By introducing these three, train feature, test feature, and label, into the classifier, we classify the image using the LIPC. The feature of train feature and test feature and label are stored in the database. These three things are introduced in the classification. Then the classification result will be shown as the text format. The classification result will discover the whether the input is the tumorous image or the non-tumorous image, and also the segmentation is improve the quality of the classification method. Now we discuss about the initial running procedure. Select the file main.m file, then right click in that file, then select the third option, run. Now the initial GUI window was opened. In that you can see several buttons. These are known as the push buttons. Now these two axes are represented as an axis. Then this one is the edit box. Now click the button input image. Now you can see the dataset folder. In that folder, you can see the several dataset images. Select any one image from the dataset. Now the selected image will be shown in the axis 1 with the title original image. Then click the button pre-processing. After the preprocessing. The preprocessed image will be shown in the axis 2 with the title filtered image. In the preprocessing, the filtered is done so that the image will be shown in axis 2 with the title filtered image. Then calculate the threshold value for the image. So we have to click the button threshold. After clicking the button threshold, the threshold value will be shown in the edit box. The threshold value is 0.23 approximately. Then click the button edge detection. After the edge detection, the edge detected image will be shown in the axis 2 with the title edge detection. For the edge detection process, we use the CanEdge method for the edge detection. After the edge detection, we use the contour based segmentation. For that, we click the contour button. This is the contour for the segmentation of the tumor region based on threshold value. Then click the button segmentation. After clicking the segmentation button, the segmented image will be shown in the axis 2 with the title tumor region segmentation. In this image, only the segmented nuclei or the segmented tumor region only will be displayed. Then click the button patch segmentation. Now the another new GUI window will be opened. In that you can see the three push buttons: patch segmentation, feature extraction and classification. First click the button patch segmentation. Now the image will be patches into the four patches. After the patch segmentation, the feature is extracted, so that click the button feature extraction. Now the feature is extracted from the four patches, so that the four rows are present in the table. The extracted values are located in the UI table. Then click the button classify. After clicking the button classify, the another new GUI window will be opened. Then that GUI window, again click the button classify. Now the train feature is shown in the UI table 1. Then the test feature is shown in the UI table 2. Now the classification result will be shown in the edit 1 and the edit box 2. The first edit box shown the result of MRI image 2. Then the second edit box shown the result of whether it is the tumor region or not. Now the classification result is tumor region first class. Then click the button graph. Then click plot graph. Here three different kinds of graph is available. The first graph represents the number of iterations and the segmentation range. Then second graph represent the intensity and the tumor level. Then this graph represent the background and the intensity difference of the background and tumor region and the whole brain region. Thank you.